revise what we have done in the last class. So first we started with seeing what is a fraction. So what's a fraction? A fraction is nothing but it is a part of a whole. Okay, so like a piece of whole pizza or a whole pie. Okay, now what is the meaning of whole? An entire circle, an entire pizza, an entire pie. These are all whole. Now when you make different parts of the pizza, okay, so that individual parts are called fractions. Okay, so a part of a whole thing is called as a fraction. Okay, and fraction can also be a part of a set. So here we have a dozen cupcakes. Dozen means how much? Dozen means 12. So one cupcake will be a part of a dozen cupcakes, so that one will be a fraction of a dozen. Okay, so that is, it is a part of one set, so that is also a fraction. Okay, so this is the meaning of fraction. Then we saw what are equal parts. So what are equal parts? Now here, if you have a chocolate and you want to divide it among two equal parts, that is, you want one equal part for you and one another equal part for your friend. So now what you'll do, you'll cut it in half, correct? So you cut it in half such that both you and your friend get two equal pieces of the chocolate. So see here, they've given you an image of the chocolate. Okay, now in the whole chocolate there are how many pieces? 8 pieces. Now so that both of you get equal, what you'll do, you'll divide it into half. So how much is half of 8? Half of 8 is 4. So you divide it such that each you and your friend, both of you get 4 pieces each. Correct? So you'll divide it in between like this. Okay, so one half of something means one part of two equal parts of that thing. Okay, when you have a whole and that you have two equal parts, half means one part of the two equal parts. Okay, so here half of this chocolate is this one part of these both equal parts. Okay, so half can be written like this, 1/2. So here this 2 represents the total number of equal parts and this 1 represents one part in that. Okay, one half in that. So this shows the fraction half. Okay, so here we saw various example. So we saw which is a half, which is not half here. The first one, since it's divided into two equal part, it is one half. Then the second shape here, the top part and the bottom part are not, both are not equal, correct? So this is not a half, this is more than half. Then here in this heart here, this heart is divided into two equal parts, so this is again a half. Then this heart, now here it is not divided into two equal parts, both are not equal, the shaded and unshaded are not equal, so this is not half. Even here the shaded is smaller than the unshaded part, so this is also not half or equal. Okay, so then the last one, see, now both these triangles are of the same shape and both are equal, so this is shows a half. Okay, now here we saw half of an orange, correct? Half of a circle, glass is half full, and half of the watermelon. This all show the fraction 1/2. Okay, here again, one half of the circle is green, so this is half. Then in this rectangle, one is red, one is yellow. So one half is red, one half is yellow. And this, in this stars, one star is gold and another is silver, correct? So one part out of two equal parts is called as a half. Okay, then we saw what is a quarter. Quarter is also called as 1/4. So quarter or 1/4. Now quarter or 1/4. Now when you have something, okay, when a whole is divided into four equal parts, okay, and each part here is called as a quarter. Now if you take a pizza and you cut the pizza into four equal parts, and from that one piece, okay, one piece is one quarter of that pizza. When you cut that pizza into four equal parts, one part will be the one quarter of that pizza. Okay, so pizza has been divided into four equal parts, one part is taken away. So that portion is said to be a quarter of the pizza. How much? It is said to be a quarter of the pizza or 1/4 of the pizza. Okay, so when we divide something into four equal parts, we cut it into quarters. A quarter means one part of four equal parts. So we write as 1/4. Okay, so we write it like this, 1/4. So here 4 represents total number of parts, that is 4, and here this on the top 1 represents how many part out of the 4 equal parts. So 1 part out of 4 equal parts is called as a quarter or 1/4. Okay, it's read either as 1/4 or 1/4. Okay, so we saw various examples of quarter. Now here this 1 square out of these 4 equal squares is 1/4. Correct? Now in this circle is divided into 4 equal parts. So one part among the 4 is a quarter. Here this hexagon is divided into 4 equal parts, and in that one part is a quarter. Same way here with this kite shape. Here one when it's divided into 4 parts, one part is 1/4, and this arrow in the 4 is 1/4. Okay, and here the star 1, 2, 3, 4, one part is shaded, which is 1/4 or quarter. Okay, these are all shapes divided into 4 equal parts. Okay, so this shows a whole or 1. Okay, this shows half, so 1/2, and these show 4 equal quarters. In that, if I take 1, it will be 1/4 or 1/4. Okay, so we saw this one whole watermelon is divided into half, then it looks like this, 1/2. Okay, and if it's divided into 4 equal parts, then it looks like this, 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, and 1/4. So each part is 1/4 or 1/4. Okay, so in today's class, now we'll study what is 3/4 or 3/4. Now, the same way when I'm dividing something into 4 equal parts. Okay, so in that part, now in 1/4 we saw that if you eat one, take 1/4 or one part of the pizza after dividing into 4 equal parts, so that is 1/4. Now, the remaining 3 pieces or 3 slices of pizza that will be remaining, that is 3/4 of the pizza. So 3 out of 4 parts are left, correct? So when you eat 1, 3 out of 4 parts are left. So these 3 parts make 3/4 or 3/4 of the pizza. So these 3 pieces of pizza make 3/4 or 3/4 of the pizza. So 3 out of 4 equal parts is known as 3/4 or 3/4. And the square, if you see, they've divided it into 4 equal quarters, and now they've shaded 3/4 here, right? So 3 out of 4. So that is 3/4 or 3/4. So 3/4 is the shaded, okay? The 3/4 of this square is shaded. So this is read as 3/4 or 3/4. Okay, so 3 out of 4 equal parts is known as 3/4 or 3/4. Alright, so this is the meaning of 3/4 or 3/4. Now here this circle. Now in this circle, it's divided into first of all 4 equal parts. And in that, how many are shaded? 3 equal parts are shaded. So 3 out of 4. So this is 3/4 again. Okay, this is 3/4 or 3/4. Now here, this shape, it's divided into 4 equal parts, and 3 out of 4 are shaded in this, correct? So this is 3/4. And this square here, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now again here, 3 out of 4 are shaded. So this is 3/4 or 3/4. Alright, so this is the meaning of 3/4. Now here there is a match the following. You have to match each of the shape to its fraction. Okay, so first one they have shown you. So this is half. It is divided into 2 halves, correct? So this is half. So it is written as half, H-A-L-F, half. And it is shown as 1/2. Now what about this one? Now if you see, it is divided into four equal parts, correct? And one is shaded, so it means it is one quarter, correct? So where is quarter? Quarter is over here. So you'll show quarter like this in words. And how do you write it in fraction? You write it in fraction as 1/4. So like this. Okay. Then this one. And if you see, the whole shape is colored, it means it is a hole. So where is the hole? It is over here. Correct? Now all the four parts are shaded, so it is 4 out of 4. Okay, so 4/4, or 4/4 is also equal to 1. Now this one. So here 3 out of the 4 are shaded, so it is 3/4. So it comes here. This is 3/4, and in fraction it is shown like this, correct? 3/4. Okay, 3/4. So this is all about fractions, that is half, 1/4, 3/4, and a whole. Okay, now let's solve the problems that are there in your textbook. So practice time on page number 129 in your textbook. So here if told, shade the following figures as given in the fraction below each. Okay, they've given a fraction below each of the shape, and you have to shade so many fractions. Okay, so first one is 3/4. So now they've divided into four parts, so we have to shade three parts of it, correct? So we'll shade three parts. So that's 1, 3. Okay. So this is 3/4. So this is how you show 3/4. Okay, then next 1/4. So we're having 4 1/4, you shade only one part. Correct. So we shade 1 square over here. So you can use different colors also. Okay. So this shows 1/4. Okay, then next one. How will you show half? That is divided into 2 equal parts. So in that you will shade. Are not equal, so put a cross mark here. Then, now in this shape here, we have four equal parts, and in that four, three are shaded, so it is 3/4 or 3/4. So 3/4. Now, in this oval, we have four equal parts in which one is shaded, so that is 1/4, okay, or 1/4. That is 1/4. Alright, so this was a chapter on fractions. So we studied what is half, what is 1/4, and what is 3/4, and we saw various questions on that. Correct? Now you have tried to do value-based question and higher order thinking skills for homework. Okay, and also do the last four questions for your homework. So you have to shade according to the fraction given below. Okay, so do this for your homework, and next class we'll do a new chapter. All right, thank you.